Once again, Dr. Hatem Eleishi from Dr. Hatem Eleishi Medical Center. Now, this video is about the second big family of medications that we use to treat patients with autoimmune rheumatic diseases. It's the biological DMARDs. Disease-modifying antirheumatic drugs, DMARDs, are medications that control the autoimmune rheumatic disease and stop its progression. This hand represents the disease, and the rope represents the DMARDs that restrain the hands from moving. There are two families of DMARDs. The first family inhibits the officer cells, that was the previous video, and they are called non-biological DMARDs. And the second family of DMARDs inhibits the go signals, or the driver molecules of inflammation, that are produced by the officer cells, and they are called biological DMARDs. For more details, refer to the video titled Types of Medications Used to Treat Autoimmune Rheumatic Diseases. This is where we introduced those terms, DMARDs and biological and non-biological DMARDs. Now, this video is about biological DMARDs. Biological DMARDs inhibit the driver molecules of the immune attack, the go signals. In medical terms, those go signals are called pro-inflammatory cytokines or pro-inflammatory molecules. They are actually different types. It's not one go. There are different goes. There's a go signal called TNF. Those are real medical terms now. TNF, another one called IL-17, IL-6, CD20, JAK, CD80, IL-23, IL-1, and more. Different types play central roles in different autoimmune rheumatic diseases. And I will explain what that means. If your autoimmune rheumatic disease is rheumatoid arthritis, this means that the specific go signals produced by the officer cells in your disease are those ones. In particular, if it's ankylosing spondylitis, those are the molecules produced. If it's psoriatic arthritis, those are the ones. You will see that there are common factors between the different diseases, but the pattern is not the same. Still's disease, those are the ones that are produced. So, if you remember this figure, those are the officer cells, those are the soldier cells. This is a happy hand that is not affected by arthritis yet. If your disease is rheumatoid arthritis and the disease button is switched on, the officer cells get activated, those are the go signals in particular that will be produced to induce the soldier cells or to stimulate them to attack the joints with antibodies. And then when they are attacked, they produce the prostaglandins or the ouch molecules that are responsible for the inflammation. Now look at the word rheumatoid arthritis in this figure, please. I will change it to psoriatic arthritis. You will find that the driver molecules are different. That's it. In psoriatic arthritis, they are different. Look at psoriatic arthritis, it will change to ankylosing spondylitis. Now the pattern becomes different. And by the way, ankylosing spondylitis doesn't attack actually the small joints of the hands. So we brought this figure to show the axial or the spine joints that are affected in ankylosing spondylitis. Blocking the pro-inflammation molecule in a given disease by a biological medication should result in good control of the inflammation of all the affected organs in that disease. This rule has few types of exceptions. I did not say few exceptions. I said few types of exceptions. And if you're a physician watching this, you will understand what I mean, of course. So this rule has few types of exceptions that are beyond the scope of those videos, but I will give you one example. For ankylosing spondylitis that typically affects the spine, some of the important options for a biological medication for you are Enbrel, Humira, Simponi, Cimzia, Remicade, and Cosentyx. If your ankylosing spondylitis also affects the colon, causing colitis, then the options become only four. Enbrel and Cosentyx are out, and you only have Humira, Simponi, Cimzia, and Remicade. So, sometimes, affection of a certain organ in the autoimmune disease mandates the use of particular biological agents from among the available options for that disease. Now, some important general data about biological medications. By the way, details of how to use each one of them and details of side effects, short-term or long-term, are not the topics of discussion in this series, maybe in another one. Now, those are the general data or the important data about the biological medications. Why are they called biological medications? Why are they called biological medications? In the broad sense, any medicine that contains any substance made in the lab from a living organism is called a biological medication. This broad definition will include vaccines, gene therapy, stem cell therapy, and biological DMARDs used in the treatment of autoimmune rheumatic diseases. Okay, what is the general rule for prescribing biological DMARDs? Give me the name of your disease and I will tell you the names of the medications that are of choice for the management of your disease with almost all of its affected organs. This is different from the non-biologicals. It was give me the name of the organ affected. About the biological medicine and the molecule it inhibits. Any biological medication will work on only one specific pro-inflammatory molecule, not more. So, if we have a biological medication that blocks TNF, this means it will block only TNF. If we have a biological medication that blocks IL-17, this means it will block only IL-17. And so on. There is currently no biological medication that works on more than one biological molecule, although attempts were made years ago for that. One specific pro-inflammation molecule can have more than one medication working to down-activate it. Like TNF, it has Enbrel, Humira, Remicade, Cimzia, and Simponi. Five different brand names, molecules acting. This is not about different commercial names. They are really different medications. And for IL-17, for example, it has Cosentyx and Taltz, two different types of medications acting on IL-17. We use only one biological medication in any patient at any single time. We don't combine any two biological medications. How do biological medicines block their target molecules? Biological medications are mostly custom-made in such a way that they bind tightly and specifically to the pro-inflammation molecule that they target. List. Now, we end with a list of the biological medications available for patient use. This is updated as of now, August 2020. Medications that block the pro-inflammation molecule that is called TNF are Enbrel, Humira, Remicade, Cimzia, and Simponi. And there are more. There are more commercial names, not brand names. Like Amjevita is another commercial name for the pharmacological Humira, which is called adalimumab. Medications that block pro-inflammation molecule IL-6, Actemra and Kevzara. IL-17, Cosentyx and Taltz. CD20, Mabthera and Benlysta. CD40, well, we mean here, if you're a physician watching this, we mean here the CTLA-4 that binds to CD40. This is not important for patients to know, but anyway, CD40 is Orencia, medication that block IL-23, Stelara and Tremfya. IL-1, this is Kineret, Ilaris and Arcalist. JAK, this is Xeljanz, Olument and Rinvoq. And with that list of biologicals, we end this video. The next video is titled Broad Lines for Prescribing a DMARD for Your Autoimmune Disease. On what basis do rheumatologists prescribe which medication to who?